This is Bryheart 84back, and today we're going to be doing a review video on a horse that I unboxed from picking up at the post office yesterday because he delivered on Saturday, but they didn't leave the box at home at my house. So, without further ado, this is the second of three Treasure Hunt Ranch Horse Mold Stallion. This is the American Paint. He's pretty nice. I actually got him a new in box off of a, from a girl that I follow, and she follows me on Instagram, so I was pretty lucky to find him for a good deal. So I'm always on the hunt for those guys that I like and I want to add to my collection, you know, if they're kind of on the old side, but I don't go past like 1994 or something like that. So he's pretty flawless, he's pretty nice. He has a one little rub right there. Just noticed that on the shoulder. I'm gonna try to use a little water to get that off. Maybe it's from paint. But it's not, if it's not, does it come off? It's just a factory farm. The other thing I noticed on him too, which is kind of expected for kind of the older guys, especially from the 90s, they tend to have a slightly unfinished paint hoof painting on their hooves. And that's a really easy fix. I've done how to do that for a couple of horses, because I have an oil-based marker that will work really, really great, because I don't have to use acrylic. But I hate to have to do that for our newer 2021st century horses, because I love the way that Briar does it, but it's like, if you spend so much money on the horse, it's kind of like, they didn't really quite finish the copy that I got, because it's kind of like a lack of craftsmanship, in my opinion. So, yeah. But anyway, it's fine. I mean, it's kind of like I guess you make your horse a little more unique than other people's copies, so the same horse. So, yeah, I guess that's fine. But, anyway, this guy looks pretty good. He's got solid black eyes, pretty nice. I know that the lighting makes him look really yellowy. There we go. He almost has an orangey buckskin color. And he has a very short dorsal stripe. It's interesting it doesn't run through his white patches. Maybe they just wanted to keep that separate. So, anyway. This is the first. I do have the first one, obviously. Is the Leopard Appaloosa. It's actually my favorite that I love out of the three. And I assume we'll be owning Cody, who is the third on this mold, of the Treasure Hunt little group, anyway, of the mold. So it's pretty nice. I really love him. This is Hank. So this Hank. This is Buster, by the way, if anybody doesn't know his name. So we got Hank, then we have Buster, and then we'll have Cody to go with these guys. Obviously, these guys are in different breed groups, but yeah, owning them is the point. So. He's in single braids conga. This guy will be wearing a raspberry pink color that I have for the paint group. So that's pretty cool. This is my, currently right now is my third horse on the mold period. Is Kashi. This is little Joe's Cartwright's horse paint. I thought it was a Pinto, but I read on his actual card and it says paint, so yeah. So Buster will be getting one of this ribbon on him today. I'll be doing that on him. The reason I'm not doing it in the video is because I did it for California Chrome, and as a step-by-step review how to do that, how to customize your own custom fit ribbon for your briars. I was doing one kind of particularly for the cigar mold, but if you want me to do it for a particular ROM model, let me know and have it down in the comments, and I'll definitely do that for you guys. And probably, I'll have a lot of time on the weekend, this coming weekend, so if you guys want me to do it by, if you want to like let me know soon by like Friday morning or something, I'll definitely carve out some time to do that for you guys especially. And it's pretty straightforward, and I'll be giving you guys a kind of a list. It's pretty similar to the other one I put on recently on my channel. But yeah, that's what it looks on these guys. This guy's so cute. I love him. Take good care of him. I mean, that's care of all of them, but yeah. Oh, another thing too, that if you guys, I don't know if you own, if you guys own this horse or seen this horse, but he actually came with horseshoes on him, so that's pretty awesome. I think he's the only one out of four traditional Cartwright horses, like the traditional size, that wears horseshoes. I don't know about his brother's horses, if they come with horseshoes, but I know Kahoshi does. Book, I have Buck, and he doesn't come. He's barefoot. He doesn't come with horseshoes. So, yeah. So this is this guy. I'll bring him closer so you can see him better. So I have done that one little shoulder rub there. Or hopefully it's not a rub. Hopefully it's just a little paint mark. I hope. I don't know. Is the bottom of the hooves that I need to do. And that's it really to kind of make him look more completely done. Other than that, he's completely flawless, no marks, no scratches, no dents, no marks of some sort. His ears are perfect. His tail's perfect. I like that half black, half white concept. It's pretty cool. Hank has that too, actually, if you look at him closer. He just has more on the tip, though. But that's alright. I really love the black and white leopard Appaloosas since I was a kid. Red and white's nice too, but I feel the black and white's more traditional. So that's pretty cool. This is a very traditional American paint horse coloring breeding. There's a lot of different type of paints. Like there's a standard brown and white alone. There's the black brown and white. This is more of the American buckskin coloring, I guess you would say. There's also standard black and white like this. So there's a lot of different genetic breeding combinations that you could have your paint turn out to be. That's where it goes of breeding. Excuse me. But yeah, that is it for this video. I still have this cardboard box. I don't know if I'm starting to say it if I want to keep it or not. But yeah, because I already have the funny thing is the ID card part talks about it's the same thing I think because Hank came in the same backing and the info card since they're the treasure hunt horses. So yeah, I don't really need that, but yeah, anyway. So yeah, I just want to show you guys this horse. And I'll be doing a game neck ribbon. Maybe going on shelf back here. He's gonna be going. You can actually see a buck right back there. Either that shelf or the next one down. I'm not exactly sure yet. I'm just kind of play with it a little bit. And so yeah, if you, I do recommend these guys. I found this guy particularly for a good deal on Instagram, but eBay is the main primary place to go. Maybe Etsy too for like older horses that are retired. Yeah, right, they're retired, and so yeah. So what I did. If you made any reviews, please let me know. And I'll get guys back to you. I do answer and read every all comments. I do contact get I have instant access through that through my phone when I'm on the go or painting, and when I'm not on my like typing on my computer. So yeah, you can definitely could do that. The lighting looks really like really pale. Oh my gosh. There we go. That's a little better. So yeah, there we go. Don't make it too dark. Okay. Okay, I guess that's the best we're gonna go. Cause yeah. Okay. But anyway, that is it for this video. I probably will do. I just finished doing a varnish on a horse. It's the Blue White Pinto. You can check that out on my Instagram. I also through my Facebook too, obviously. But anyway, I'll be doing a review video on customs. I'm still trying to sell the ones that are finished anyway. And I'll be doing that tomorrow after I get home from work because I have my other job. So I have like two jobs basically. This business, the horse customized business, and then the business I have to, a job that I have to go to, I have to travel to. I'll do that in the morning. So that is what's going on right now. So let's see, what are videos? I think that's it for, I know that I need to do videos right now, but yeah. So I need to still upload my review video, unboxing video on Illumination. So I'll be doing that tonight, and you guys can check that out once that's up. All right. Have a good night, everybody, and see you next video.